fact that he is mostly a mad genius, but he's also creepy at the same time. But he embraces that and makes it his own, as well as he presents it to others as, if, hey, you're the outcast, you don't fit in, whatever, you become successful in your own way, and you find happiness. And that's his main story, in all from, like, Coraline to Nightmare Before Christmas to even Mars Attacks, that everybody finds happiness in the end, and that's what he wants everybody to feel when he, when, like, he meets the outcasters, because he was one. So his own success, he wants to build that off of other people and have other people feel inspired by him. So with Tim Burton, he is just crazy in all these ideas. He wants you to feel creeped out. He wants you to feel as if creepy crawlies are all over you. But also he wants you to feel successful and happy and feel like you can connect with these lovable characters that are in his crazy tales. So first off, he was actually barely 20 years old, and he was at his animation peak as he was going to college and everything, and he actually found a fellowship from Disney, and so he actually got picked up by Disney in that way, and then he actually helped create Fox and the Hound. I can't tell if you can see, but this is the fox and the birds and everything, so it's a scene from it. So he actually worked on animation with that, even though that is completely nothing relatable to what he's doing now. And so he kind of could do his own little thing. Disney let him do small, short clips of black and white stories that were actually very disturbing. So they actually never got aired, but later on, actually, Stephen King found them, and he was like, yeah, you need to do your own thing. You need to get out there into the world. And so with Burton's movies, a really awesome thing about his movies is that he has made 30-plus. Half of them haven't even been aired, and half of them are just very small films, but no one has really seen them. And with these 30 films, such as like Alice in Wonderland or even Corpse Bride or anything like that, he has been awarded 67 plus awards from various little get togetherings or even like big awards. So there's Johnny Depp and Tim Burton, because Johnny Depp's in every single one of his movies. You should just make a movie about Johnny Depp, and he's holding his award right there. And it's just very interesting of how many things he can be accomplished from all these films that he has created but no one's really seen, but everybody seems to appreciate them. And then last but not least, a few interesting stories of how, if you notice that every one of his main male characters kind of look similar in the facial structures, because he felt as if these characters are visions of himself and that he wants to have all of his movies be inspired by himself. And so he actually took every single one of these stories, and the whole purpose of them are stories of his own life, his growing up, childhood, and he feels as if that he can twist them and make them feel relatable to other people, and that people want to, and he wants them to feel as inspired from these movies, taking them back as he put into them. And so Tim Burton is my inspiration just because he is just very accomplished in what he does. He feels very strongly about how he creates his own characters, make them into lovable stories that people can remember.